Hollywood 19911. Our subjects appear to be many. Our guest appears to be one woman with many, many, many ideas. Miss Ayn Rand, authoress of Atlas Shrugged, The Fountainhead, We the Living, Anthem, The Virtue of Selfishness, and umpteen papers. I'm Michael Jackson, KNX, hello. Miss Rand is on the line.
Thank you. Miss Rand, I have recently been introduced to philosophy and objectivism by your books, and I would very much appreciate your opinion on a problem I run into. I would like your opinion, if you have any knowledge of him, of Tom Dooley, Dr. Tom Dooley?
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
He died about a year and a half, or perhaps 2 years ago. He was an American doctor who went out to the Orient and worked amongst the natives and was very much revered.
I know the name, but I don't know very much about him.
Oh, I see. Go ahead, ma'am.
Well, I had the opinion, more or less, that he was accidentally thrown into this situation in the East because he was in the Navy as a doctor, and that it was only then, when he was with these people, that he became interested in them more as a personal matter than a sociological one. I was wondering if under those circumstances you think that this, well, it was almost a self-sacrifice, could have been acceptable under the objectivist philosophy.
That depends actually on his motive. I have heard, but do not know how reliably, that he had actually very good scientific motives. But what the objectivist philosophy would say as a principle is this. If you want to help others, and you can do so without sacrificing yourself, then it is proper. If it is a sacrifice, then one shouldn't. Now, what do I mean by sacrifice? A sacrifice means the surrender of a lesser, of a greater value, for a lesser value or a non-value. Therefore, in this case, if Dr. Dooley wanted to do something else, wanted it more, but gave it up because the people needed him, that would be a sacrifice, and that would be improper. Mm. But if he was a scientist, and he was pursuing his own career, and he wanted to help these people because it was a scientific problem in very difficult and tragic circumstances, then he was acting properly. The whole issue, of course, only he himself could answer it. But what I'm saying is that he must not, and no one must, give up their greatest values for the sake of helping others. That is self-sacrifice. But merely undertaking a difficult job of helping others when it coincides with your own interests, scientific or professional, that is quite proper. In fact, that's heroic.
Miss Rand, perhaps Nathaniel Brandon sums it up when he says no one ever really sacrifices himself.
When did Nathaniel Brandon say that?
In his paper, Isn't Everyone Selfish? And he goes on to say, since every purposeful action is motivated by some value or goal that the actor desires, one always acts selfishly, whether one knows it or not. But do you accept that?
Look, I think it is truly contemptible, if you will forgive me, to quote anyone that way. You're quoting Mr. Brandon's presentation of the very viewpoint that he is opposing. The article is entitled, Isn't Everyone Selfish? And Mr. Brandon proves precisely the opposite of the view which you are quoting and which he quotes as the enemy view.
Fine. Now then we get an answer from you.
Turn, please, to the last paragraph, the concluding paragraph of that article, and read it to us.
Mm-hmm. All right. A genuine selfishness, that is, a genuine concern with discovering what is to one's self-interest, an acceptance of the responsibility of achieving it, a refusal ever to betray it by acting on the blind whim, mood, impulse, or feeling of the moment, an uncompromising loyalty to one's judgment, convictions, and values, represents a profound moral achievement. Those who assert that everyone is selfish, and that's in quotations, commonly intend their statement as an expression of cynicism and contempt. But the truth is that their statement pays mankind a compliment that it does not deserve.
That's it. Now you see that is quite clearly stated. He does not believe that everyone is selfish because they act on some kind of motive. Mm-hmm. That is precisely the idea he is opposing and I am opposing.
Good. Ma'am, I hope that in part answers your question.
Very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Good night.